So I got some good news today. I'm going to show you that the FTC6H is working. So as you can see, when I pull the trigger, the hammer will fall. You can see it right there. So now the hammer is still up. I insert the magazine. And you see it stops firing and the hammer is still up, not all the way up. You can release the magazine. If you charge the system, you can drop the hammer again. If you insert an empty magazine with gas inside, you can drop the hammer, nothing will happen. Now I charge the system back, put the magazine in, again, hammer is up, now put in a HPA, capacitor, so that's it. So what does this mean for this project? It means that after 2 years, I just look back when I first started working on this, it's finally getting done. Meaning that that basically is working now. But because it have taken 2 years and I've kind of made a lot of side projects that you have noticed, like the Springer edition, the Open Bolt edition, all in order to complete this one. Because it was so complicated to finish this one. So there's a lot of old parts I kind of have to look over, like what is the current one. A lot of beta edition parts that are not good, some were good. I kind of sift those out. So I will be making another one. Do some testing with that one as well to confirm that it is the correct part and not with one small tolerance that I did not notice. And then make a package of it. Of course, with both of them, some detailed testing, so I know what spring settings you have to use, what kind of FPS it's recommended. I already started it with this one, with the air pressure testing and things like that. So I know that it's kind of a wide tolerance of it working. So that's good. So it's not just a barely function system. Then of course I need to make the manual. And for me, since I'm dyslexic, it takes some time. And also I kind of want to go in detail so it's clear. So yeah, it doesn't mean that it's ready next week or something like that. But it means like, okay, it's gonna happen. And I'm working on it. Of course I do also some other projects that I need to work on, so it's not like I can work full time on it, but I will be fast with it because I do want to release it after all this time. And I'm really happy that it's finally a thing, because I have moments that I was thinking like it's not gonna happen. Then I needed to drop it because I was kind of stuck on it, and that's why the side projects were born. And kind of figuring things out that did work and kind of try to make something out of that one and kind of learn from it, let's say. And it's really cool that it's now finally there. Yeah, I will of course announce it when it's finally officially a thing. I was already working on the uppers. The uppers are the same as from the FTC9. But there's also some special uppers that have a smooth side, so there's no bump on the sides. Those will be already released. We released relatively soon. And also, in case you like to have this one with a big opening, so you can kind of see what's going on, maybe for building one, or maybe just because you find it fun to see the hammer drop. Maybe as a teaching thing that you kind of want to demonstrate how an let's say FTC9 works. Kind of demonstrate that without the risk of actually be able to fire in real round. That can be a thing that you kind of wanted. Of course, when you are going to play airsoft, things like that, you wanted to have it close because it's asking for dirt and things to get in there and it needs to run smooth. But at the same time, it's kind of fun to see. So for myself, I keep one like this and a one that's like an FTC9 normal configuration. And yeah. But yeah, see you guys next time, and hopefully with a fun update that it's ready. But that will be, oh well, unfortunately, it will be not so fast. But the good news is it's finally done, it's working. And yeah, that's great. So that means after this one, that all my big projects that I was working on in a couple years kind of are done. And I do have some new things in mind. But first I wanted to round this type of projects up. So that's kind of done. Yeah. Also, one thing, because there's certainly interest in the spring edition. Out of nowhere, I might take a look at that one after this one is finished, and probably also when the FA manual is updated with, let's say, a clean release. But maybe I do it before that, because I've done some thinking, like I probably can make a better piston just by looking at airsoft pistols that are springers. Should not be that hard to have kind of a better piston thing going on that's right now. And also the syringe thing, it got way too much friction. It got a good air seal, but it's way too tight and slows the thing down. You need to put a lot of spring pressure. That's kind of some way even dangerous assembling it, and maybe even it's should not be that much more than a 9mm, of course, and all the bolt weight. But still, there was some things that I think I did not make it necessarily better, I think, with the syringe. So I might take a look at that one, because it's just a drop-in kit, it's really simple. Might want to take a look at the parts again, because it's so long ago. Might update it a little bit, let's call it that way. But yeah, anyways. Also very important about the Hammer edition. There will be no full auto edition. Maybe at a later date. But I don't really see the point, since there's already the open bolt edition that is full auto or semi-automatic, depending on how you set it up. And the bolt thing was working, what I showed before. That's why I was thinking that it could be a thing. The only thing is I need to make a mechanism in the back that you, basically what I kind of want is just a drop-in part on the back that makes it so that the hammer cannot follow the bolt when it's still in traveling, and that would slow the hammer down because it's already hitting the bolt and then you did not have enough power to cycle. That was really a big issue. And I was thinking, like, do I really want to go and make that part? Let's just drop that and just focus on the semi-automatic. And I'm glad that I did, because first I had trouble running this one. But I'm glad that I just starting to try a lot of things with the compressed air, different settings, different springs. And then just at the point that it started running, and then I could also use the green gas, and yeah, that's the way to go. So it's maybe also one tip for people who are kind of interested in building an airsoft thing that you 3D print. It's really handy to have the compressed air, because then when you have the compressed air, you can adjust really accurately the pressure. And then it's really easy to see, like, okay, does this spring really work well on high pressures? High pressures, for airsoft speaking at least. Or does it want to run really on low pressures? Because it's really an imbalance you need to have in mind when you have the hammer spring. So that's really nice about it. But But that makes it also for me really easy to test, like, okay, this spring and this spring makes it a really wide spectrum of adaptability, let's say. And not that it is just running on a certain pressure range and really narrow. That's really nice about it, about something like that. So I don't pick a random spring that's like, okay, it works, and then you take your green gas, your room temperature, it's really a little bit lower or higher, and it doesn't work. So yeah, that's really important when you make something like this, so people don't run all kind of issues when they start to build it.